Okay, this is a brief introduction to the mix window. So this whole time we've been in this window, which is called the edit window. The edit window looks like a timeline that you would see in Premiere or Media Composer, but it's all audio, and it goes left to right. Doesn't really look like an audio board though. So it doesn't really look like a mixing board. It looks more like an editing station on a computer, which is what it is. So there's another window that lets us access controls that are more mix board-like, and it's called the mix board. So you can go up to window, see we're in the edit window, we can go to the mix window. And just another note, Pro Tools is a big, it's got basically shortcuts for everything. Apple equals, or I guess that would be Command equals on a PC, does the same thing. It's a great shortcut to know. So you click on that, boom, look at this. We've got tracks that are the same as the tracks in the mix window, or in the edit window, but it's in the mix window. Let's go back to the edit window one more time. So we've got Ugly Duckling, video track, not audio, just a video track. But then audio-wise, we've got dialogue, VO, music, effects, Atmos, which is basically another effects track, and then a master track, which we can route everything to, which we'll get into later. So dialogue, VO, music, FX, Atmos, and master. So we can go up to window, go to the mix, or just hit command equals, boom. And what do we have here? We have dialogue, VO, music, FX, Atmos, master. Now the mix window can have a different order than the edit window if you want. And remember, the order of tracks is supposed to go dialogue, VO, ADR, basically anything that involves humans talking as your main source of audio. That goes on the top, followed by effects like room tone, explosions, any sort of effect. Then Foley, which is a special, it's his own, like, it's kind of like an effect, basically. It's got its own category, though. And then music at the bottom. So we don't have any Foley in this one, but we do have dialogue, VO, effects, and music. So we put the music over here. So, and then master, everything is going to get mixed to the master last. But for those who are familiar with mixing boards, sure enough, we've got our faders right here. We have our panning between left and right, right there. And then we have our inserts right here. So remember before I was talking about insert effects. Well, our insert effects are easily accessible right here. So the mix window does have some limitations in the sense that you can't affect specific clips. You're just working with tracks. Because look, where are the clips? They are in the edit window. We actually see them and can move them around. The mix window, you can't move stuff around because it has one function, to mix in an interface that feels like a real mixing board. So.
No, I don't think a jump start's gonna do it. No, I don't think a jump start's gonna do it. No, I don't
think a jump start's gonna do it. No,
I don't think a jump start's gonna do it. No, I don't think a jump start's gonna do it. No, I don't think a jump start's gonna do it.
See it, turn the music down.
I jump start's gonna do it.
Brought it up.
I don't think a jump start's
gonna do it.
No, I don't think a jump start's gonna do it. No, I don't think a jump start's gonna do it.
And this is the master, which brings everything down. If you've ever worked with a mixing board, these are what we call channels. And all the channels route to the master, which controls everything. So this is a good way to say, you know what, this music's a little loud. Let's bring it down. Now it's too quiet. Let's bring it up. That's a little nicer. His voice is a little loud. Let's bring it down. And then, of course, we'll get into things like clipping. Right now, these levels are a little low, so we could probably bring the dialogue up a little bit. That's looking a little better. We still have access to things like solo, which solos this track, cuts out all the other ones, or mute, which mutes this one, but we still hear all the other ones. So we have all this functionality in the edit window, but if you're more familiar with the mixing board, then this stuff just kind of comes out as more obvious. And then, of course, if we want to add effects, if we want to deal with sends, which we'll talk about that a little later. And just so you could see a little sneak preview of something we're going to do in the mix window in the future, automation. Automation lets you basically automate your mixes. What do I mean by that? Watch. First, you want to go up to Window, down to Automation, and make sure that your automation is on. How do you know that it's on? Because suspend is not selected. A lot of times it's suspended by default. It's a good thing, and you'll see why, because automation can get you into trouble if you don't know what you're doing. So we want to make sure it's not suspended, and that volume, panning, muting, and plugins are all selected. You can leave these guys selected too, but these are the main ones right here, volume, pan, mute, and plugin. So those are all selected. That means those will all work as automated tasks. So,
rah! Yes. What? And then it's making sort of a boom.
Okay. So that explosion is pretty loud and pretty reverby. I want to fade it down sooner. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to automate it. Right here it says automation. I'm going to say right. And so now when I play it, as I play it, I am going to change the output of this channel, basically the volume, by moving the fader up and down. Watch.
Rah! Yes. What? And then it's making sort of a
now I'm going to bring it back up.
A kaboom. No, I don't think it jumped.
Okay. So after you're done, like, basically, like, automating, you always want to go back to read, because if you don't, then it could, when you play it again, you could accidentally write over what you just did. So now, let's play this back.
Rah! Yes!
See, what? That's the move I just did. No hands. See that?
A kaboom!
So as we work on our mixes, we will be basically going through channel by channel and basically automating them. Sometimes we want the dialogue to be loud, sometimes we want it to be quiet. Same thing with the music, same thing with the effects, same things with all the tracks. And then at the end, when we do our bounce, all of these levers will have been automated and you will get the mix that you want after days or even weeks of meticulously, like, pushing the faders up and down to get each channel to sound the way you want. And the best way to do that is in the mix window. So consider this be a little sneak preview of that.